The future is here, and you're invited. The next step for Porsche and, eventually, Audi. The first product developed on Volkswagen Group's premium platform electric is the new all-electric Porsche Macan, which can be seen under all that black vinyl and flimsy covering. PPE will also be delivering an all-new line of Audis and Porsches that run on electricity. After driving a prototype of the new Macan around the streets of California for a day, I can confidently state that the future is bright. Bright, but perhaps possibly a little cloudy. Even if it's a Macan with electric propulsion, it won't be named a Macan EV or Macan Electric. Macan is its name, and even though it won't hit stores until early 2024, the internally combusted version won't disappear anytime soon. There will soon be not one but two Macan models available at dealerships, each built on a distinct platform. Confusing? A little bit, maybe, but this is unquestionably the option you should go with. Generation next. The Taycan is one of the best opening acts around. Porsche's first electric vehicle, EV, was more successful than others in making the leap from beautiful concept to much sought-after production vehicle. Having just driven the new Macan, I can say with confidence that it won't suffer from second album syndrome. First, let's get the most important numbers out of the way we can. Porsche is still keeping many details of this matter under wraps, so we may not be dealing with all of the information at our disposal. Porsche estimates that the electric Macan's range will be well beyond 500 kilometers on the European WLTP test, and the PPE platform will provide a battery pack with a capacity of roughly 100.0 kilowatt-hours to achieve this goal. That's an increase from the Taycan's 246-mile maximum range to somewhere north of 310 miles. This, however, is on the much more rigorous EPA test cycle. There is a lot of guesswork involved in predicting the Macan's EPA-rated range in the United States, but a number in the 275-300-mile range appears feasible. And what about authority? All Macans will include a standard dual-motor AWD system, although buyers can choose from three output levels. Porsche has not decided how to brand this vehicle, although it will likely follow the naming conventions of the Taycan and be sold as a Macan 4, 4S, and Turbo at dealerships. Again, Porsche doesn't list exact horsepower, but I was informed the top-tier turbo version might produce around 450 kilowatts. The figure is little higher than 600 horsepower. The current top-tier Macan GTS has 434 horsepower. That is a significant increase. Porsche has not announced an exact amount, but it is safe to assume that it will be significantly heavier than the GTS's 4,400-pound curb weight. To top it all off, the price of the electric Macan is yet unknown, although it's safe to assume it will be more than the Macan GTS's starting MSRP of over $85,000.